If you've never seen one of these before, it plays a key role in your internet life. This is what carries your email, videos, and games all around the world. It's an undersea internet cable. It's being made right here in Kitakyushu, Japan, at NEC's OCC factory. OCC makes submarine cables, which carry virtually all internet data across oceans. The cables come in different varieties, including heavily armored ones, but they all start with bundles of optical fibers. The fibers are wrapped in layers for strength, starting with a steel tube, then steel wires and a copper tube, and finally a polyethylene sheath for water resistance. Enormous spinner machines and spools are needed to create the cables. When they're armored, the cables are wrapped in more steel wires and then asphalt and plastic strings. That makes them pretty tough.
Even though single armor is just one layer, this is kind of difficult to bend.
Once manufacturing is complete, the cables are spooled into large tanks and then tested for water resistance and other parameters. The cable system includes large missile-shaped repeaters to boost the signal across the ocean. This 9,000 kilometer long cable is being created for the Trans-Pacific Faster cable that's backed by Google.
It is a 6 fiber pair system. Each fiber pair will carry 100 wavelengths of 100 gigabits. So the total capacity will be around 60 terabits. That is equivalent to about 1600 DVDs, which can be transmitted over the ocean in 1 second.
Once it's ready, the cable is sent out along rollers to a cable ship docked by the factory. This is the René Descartes, owned by French telecom firm Orange. Dozens of workers are needed to load the cable, as well as the large repeater units, onto the ship. Once inside, the cable is fed into 3 tanks below the main deck, and they're huge, hot, and humid. The cable has to be looped very carefully to prevent tangles. Back up on the main deck, we can see a few of the tools needed to lay the cable. About the size of a small house, the plow Elodie is used to dig trenches on the coastal seabed where the cable needs to be buried for protection from anchors and nets. Next up is the Hector 6, an ROV that can work up to 2,000 meters below the surface of the ocean. It has caterpillar tracks for propulsion, jets to help bury the cable in its trench, as well as robotic arms to manipulate it. On the bridge, engineers can control the arms with small-scale replicas, as well as joysticks to control the ROV and plow. It takes a light touch and a lot of patience to install a cable all the way across the Pacific. In Kitakyushu, Tim Horniak, IDG News Service.